Amud Ein Hey, Tractate Chulin, fourth chapter. Name of the chapter is Beima Maksha. Start from the words Man Tono. Man Tono, Vabino, Uchsha, Allah, Havizak, Vos Nitma. Who is the Tana who teaches that the Ben Pekua passed through the street? Passed through a stream. It has been prepared for Tuma. And if it then went into a graveyard, it has been contaminated, even though it is yet alive. Omar Rabbi Yochanan, Rabbi Yisya Glili, it's the opinion of Rabbi Yisya Glili. Tani Rabbi Shimon Lozor, Rabbi Shimon Yisya Glili. Rabbi Shimon ben Lozor says in the name of Yisya Glili, Metam etumas ochlim, Ben Pekua contracts the tumah of foods, Retzorich Hechsher, and it requires preparation for tumah. V'chachomim meimrim, Eino metam etumas ochlim, Ben Pekua does not contract the tumah of foods, Neishu chai, it's not considered dead, Chol shu chai, Eino metam etumas ochlim, anything that is alive does not contract the tumah of foods. So the sages agree with Rabbi Yisya Glili that Ben Pekua may be eaten without Shechita in accordance with the sages of our Mishnah. Nevertheless, they do not view the Ben Pekua as an edible food in as so far as declaring it susceptible to tumor. Rather, they maintain that since it is physically alive, it is immune to tumor despite its permissibility for consumption. Rabbi Yisya Glili alone takes the position that since the Ben Pekua is fit to be eaten without Shechita, it is considered a food in regard to Tuma even while alive. The previous Baisa follows the opinion of Rabbi Yisya Glili. The Gemara comments about Rabbi Yochanan's interpretation of this dispute. Ve'azdu Rabbi Yochanan Tame. Rabbi Yochanan follows his own reasoning. Doma Rabbi Yochanan said, Rabbi Yisya Glili uveshamayim udover echot. Rabbi Yisya Glili and Beishamai said the same thing, that a living creature which may be eaten without Shechita is considered a food even in so far may be eaten without a food even in as so far as being susceptible to tumor. So that a living creature which may be eaten without Shechita is considered a food even in so far as being susceptible to tumor. Lily said this in that ruling which we just cited. Beis Shammai also said that. But Shammai also said this, the Tanya we learned in a Mishnah Dogim and Moslem Kabim Tumor. From what point do fish acquire the tumor of food? Beis Shammai Imri Mishir Tsudu, Vesil Imri Mishir Musu. Beis Shammai said from the moment that they were caught, they can acquired tumor. Beis Hillel says from the time when they actually die. Rabbi Akiva says from the time when they are unable to leave. Beis Shammai's opinion that flesh, that fish are susceptible to tumor even before they die parallels with Rabbi Yisya Glili's opinion regarding a Ben Pekua. The Gemara focuses on the opinion of Beis Hillel and Rabbi Akiva. Mai benayu, what is the practical difference between them? Amar Rabbi Yochanan, Davim karta ika benayu. There is a difference between them regarding a threshing fish, meaning the fish is about to die, whose death is inevitable. Beis Hillel maintained that since it is still alive, it is not susceptible to tumor. But Rabbi Akiva maintains that once it has reached the point where it will not be able to survive, even if returned to the water, it is regarded as having died and is susceptible to tumor.
So, can I ask a question? They're telling that if you kill the mother, if you shock the mother, the baby is okay to eat, yeah?
Not according to Rabbi Meir, according to Chachamim.
So according to Chachamim. So, but if the baby is alive, how are you going to eat the baby alive?
So you're allowed to kill it in you're allowed to sever the pipe, not like not shechita. You're allowed to sever the pipe. So if I consider it alive, then it's not susceptible to tumor. But if I say it's dead,
then
it's like meat in the pot, like they said. Then it's like food. And if it's food, then it's susceptible to tumor. By Rav Chisda, noldu bedogim siman treifo, if signs of treifo developed in fish. Now, what is the law according to Rabbi Akiva? Is the fish susceptible to tuma of foods or not? So it's an interesting scenario. What does it mean? Simone Trefo. So he gives an example. He said, if a fish developed a hole in its intestines. Now, what is the law? Tibor l'mandomot treifo chayo. This may be inquired according to the one who said that treifo animal can survive. V'siboi l'mandomot treifo chayo. And it may be inquired according to the one who said that treifo animal cannot survive. Look at 13, it says, the Gemara above, 42a, 57b, cited dispute whether the trefa defects are all fatal and guarantee an animal's death within a short time, either 30 days or 12 months, or it is possible for an animal to survive indefinitely with such a defect.
We see all these cows that got the lung defects in the lungs that are treifa, and they were walking around like nothing was wrong with them until the shechita.
The question is, they are able to live like this for 12 months?
Would this be like hooks that are, like some fish have hooks stuck in them that went through the flesh?
No, over here it's speaking about the intestines. If the intestines had a hole. This may be inquired according to the one who said a treifa animal can survive. May be inquired according to the one who said that a treifa animal cannot survive. May be inquired according to the one who said that a treifa animal can survive as follows. Perhaps it is only an animal that can survive with a treifa defect, since it has a great degree of visibility. Aval dogim de loy nefisho chayusayo. But as for fish which do not have a great degree of visibility, loy, they are not capable of surviving without a treifa defect. Therefore, any fish with such a defect is automatically regarded as though it is already dead, in so far as being susceptible to tuma to the tuma of foods. Or perhaps afilu mandoma treifa in Ohio, even according to the one who said that a treifa animal cannot survive, and who certainly also holds that a fish with a treifa defect cannot survive. Hanemile beima diyesh b'mino shchita. That the concept of treifa applies only to an animal whose kind is subject to shechita. Aval dogim, the ain b'minan shechita. When it comes to fish, you don't need to shecht it. They're not subject to shechita. Eim aloy, I can say that the concept of treifa does not apply to them at all. Accordingly, even when a fish develops a treifa defect, the fact that it is incapable of surviving has no legal ramifications, and the fish therefore remains unsusceptible to tuma until it actually dies. The Gemara offers no resolution to the inquiry, but it concludes, Teiku. Let it stand. So if a fish has a trefa, developed a trefa signs, there's no answer whether it's a trefa or not. Etilo nefel, if an animal miscarried, the status of the fetus, of its fetus, chelev, is disputed. Rabbi Yochanan Omar, Rabbi Yochanan said, chelev ke chelev behima. The fetus chelev is considered like the chelev of a behima, and thus prohibited on pain of chorus. Rabbi Shimon ben Lakish Omar, chelev ke chelev chayo. But Rabbi Shimon ben Lakish said, the fetus chelev is considered like the chelev of a chayo, which is excluded from the Torah's prohibition. Rabbi Yochanan Omar, chelev ke chelev behima. Rabbi Yochanan said that its chelev is considered like the chelev of behima avir agorim, because the mere emergence of a behema fetus into the air causes it to be classified as a behema, even if it was not carried to its full term. Rabbi Shimon Lakish Omar, chelev ke chelev chayo. His chelev is considered like the chelev of a chayo, non-domesticated animal. Chadoshim gromei, because the conclusion of a fetus month in the womb causes it to be classified as behema when it subsequently emerges. So if it wasn't concluded, the month wasn't concluded, then maybe you can call it chayo. Ika deomri kol eichad le kolu chadosho. Whenever the first month in the womb were not included, loy klumu, all agree that it is nothing. Kip ligay, where do Rabbi Yochanan Rosh Lakish disagree? Eichad deoshid yodu le mei veimu. V'tola shchelu shebebo tisho, ben tisho chay veocha. If, it's a little bit graphic and gruesome, it is regarding a case where one extended his hand into an animal's womb, tore off chelev of a live 9-month fetus that was inside and ate it. Rabbi Yochanan said the fetus chelev is considered like the chelev of behema. Chadoshim gormei, because the mere conclusion of a fetus month in the womb causes it to be classified as a behema even before it emerges into the air. Rabbi Shimon Lakish Omar, chelev ke chelev chayo, chadoshim avir gromei. Shimon Lakish said that its chelev is considered like the chelev of a chayo, therefore permitted, because the conclusion of a fetus month in the womb and its subsequent emergence into the air causes it to be classified as behema before it emerges from the womb. It is not considered a behema, and its chelev is excluded from the prohibition. Eisi v'Rabbi Yochanan Rabbi Shimon ben Lakish, ma'u chelev? Rabbi Yochanan challenged Rabbi Shimon ben Lakish, said, one second, what is chelev? Ma chelev u'shtechlois amuris ba'osho mutsu miklashli. Just as the chelev and two kidneys are mentioned regarding the osham offering are excluded from being those of a fetus. Afkal mutso miklal shilid. So too in the case of every offering where the chelev and two kidneys are mentioned, they are excluded from being those of a fetus. The Torah added a pasuk in the passage of Asham to teach that as a general rule, when a pregnant female is sacrificed, the chelev of a fetus is not offered on the altar. Bish lemaladidi, all is well according to me, according to the one who says that regarding the prohibition of eating chelev, an unborn fetus is treated like a behema once it has reached its full term. Hainu de itzich kol ma'uti, that is why a pasuk is needed to exclude its chelev from being offered on the altar. Ela lidoch ba, according to you, to the one who says that an unborn fetus is considered a behema even when it has reached its full term, amaitzich, why the pasuk is needed? Since the fetus is not behema, its fat is not in the category of chelev at all. and must obviously not be offered on the altar. Omar Lei, so Ushlakish responds to Rabbi Yochanan, Time Mutidi Namimarach, my opinion is indeed derived from here, from the very fact that the Torah excludes the chelev of a fetus from being offered, I infer that it is legally not in the category of chelev, even regarding the prohibition. Had the Torah not excluded it here, we might have thought that it is considered chelev in all respect and must be offered on the altar. A variant version of the preceding challenge, Ve'ikad Amrei, Sivei Rabbi Shimon ben Lakish L'Rabbi Yochanan, it was Rabbi Shimon ben Lakish who challenged Rabbi Yochanan. From the following Bais Amar, Chelev u'shtei chloyos amoros b'rosh u'mutzu miklal shelil, just as chelev and two kidneys that are mentioned regarding the Hashem offering are excluded from being those of a fetus, of kol mutzu miklal shelil, so too in the case of every offering where the chelev and two kidneys are mentioned, they are excluded from being those of a fetus. The Torah teaches that when a pregnant female is sacrificed, the chelev of a fetus is not offered on the altar. Moses Bishlam Alididi Ol is well according to me, according to the one who says that chelev of an unborn fetus is not in the prohibited category, even when it has reached its full term. Mishumachi miyati rachmono. That is why the merciful one excludes it from being offered on the altar. Elo ledidoch, but according to you who says that the chelev of an unborn fetus is prohibited for consumption once it has reached its full term, li korev, let it be offered on the altar. According to this version, Rabbi Yochanan responds, Omar lei, said to Rav Shlakish, midi d'ava mechusar zman. The merciful one excluded from being offered because it is analogous to an animal that is premature with respect to being offered. The Gemara turns to another issue. Omar Rabbi Yami, Ashechet Satrefa Umotzav Ventisho. Umotzav Ventisho Chai. If one slaughters a trefo animal and finds a live 9-month fetus in it. So now the issue is the mother is not good, right? Trefo. But the fetus is full-term fetus. Ledivrei Oiser, according to the one who prohibits a full-term fetus that is found in the womb of a healthy animal that was slaughtered, Rabbi Meir, who states that in our Mishnah, that the ben pekua may not be eaten unless it itself is slaughtered. Matir, he permits the full-term fetus of a trefa on the basis of its own shechita. The Divya Amalibi, according to the one who permits a full-term fetus that is found in the womb of a healthy animal that was slaughtered, Rabbi Yehuda, who maintains that a ben pekua may be eaten on the basis of its mother's shechita, oyser, he prohibits the full-term fetus of a trefa, even if this fetus is slaughtered, because the shechita of the mother was not good. The mother was trefa. So, really, Rabbi Yehuda says that the fetus is attached, is one with the mother. And therefore, you don't have to shechtat, but if the mother was trefa, then it's also trefa. Rabbi Meir says it's two separate things. And therefore, you have to shecht the fetus. And if you have to shecht the fetus, then it should be okay.
Rabbi, I have a doubt here. They started this argument, this discussion. The Rabbi Shimon ben Lakish said that the chelev is considered like chelev of a chaya, so it's excluded from the Torah prohibition. So why they don't agree with this? The chelev of chaya is permitted to
correct.
So no.
Why? Yes.
Chaya doesn't get offered on the mizbeach.
No.
The deer.
Not offered on the mizbeach, but it's permitted to be eaten.
The consumption.
Yeah, sure.
So it's not okay. It's not kosher. They don't agree with this.
That's what we're going through.
No, that we're trying.
It's not a fact. Like it's not.
It is a fact, but we're trying to find out how do I treat the chelev of ben pekua. How do I treat the chelev of the fetus? Am I considering it chayah or am I considering it beim?
That's not decided yet.
Yeah, because if you say that it's that it cannot be offered on the altar, maybe it's chaya, because chaya was not offered on the altar. And then maybe I can eat it. If you say it's a behema,
then you're allowed to offer.
They're allowed to offer it on the altar, but you're not allowed to eat it.
Okay.
Even according to the one who permits a full term. Even according to the one who permits a full-term fetus that is found in the womb of a healthy animal that was slaughtered, Rabbi Uda, i.e. Rabbi Uda, the full-term fetus of a trefa is permitted on the basis of its own shechita. Arbo simonin achshav berachwan. The merciful one validated four pipes for the slaughter of a full-term fetus. If one slaughters a trefa animal and finds a life, 9-month fetus in it. Ton shchito v'chayov bizroya v'alechayayim v'akevo. It requires shchito. And it is subject to the requirement of giving the foreleg, the jaws, and the abomasum to a kohen, ve'imeis, and if it died without having been slaughtered, tohir melatam b'maso, it is pure for of conveying tuma through carrying. It is not subject to the tuma of nevela. Amar le rabo, rabo sato of chizda ton shechita keman. In accordance with whom do you rule that the fetus requires shechita in order to be eaten? And that it is permissible on the basis of that shechita. Ki Rabbi Meir, presumably in accordance with Rabbi Meir. The rabbis of our Mishnah would not permit it on the basis of its own shechita because they view it as having already been slaughtered while in the womb of its trefa mother. And in accordance with whom do you rule that it is subsequently, that if it subsequently dies without having been slaughtered, it is pure of conveying tuma through carrying, because its mother's shchita has spared it from being considered nevela? Kerabon, keman kerabon. Presumably it is in accordance with the rabbis who regard the mother's shchita as effective for her full-term fetus. How can you reconcile these rulings? And according to your reasoning, how the son of Rabbi Chia, the following b'risa that was taught by Rabbi Chia, asher et ha-trefa u'motzavo ben chai tisho chai. If one slaughters a trefa and finds a live 9-month fetus inside it, ton shechito, the fetus requires shechito, in order to be permitted for consumption, and it is subject to the requirement of giving the foreleg, the jaws, and the abomasum to the kohen, and if it died without having been slaughtered, it is pure of conveying tuma through carrying. In accordance with whom does the Baisa rule that the fetus requires shchita? Ki Rabbi Meir, you will presumably say that it is accordance with Rabbi Meir. And in accordance with whom does the Braisa rule that if the fetus dies without having been slaughtered, it is pure of conveying tuma through carrying kerabon? Presumably in accordance with the rabbis, according to your reasoning, the Braita is self-contradictory. Rabbi responds, Halei kasha, that is not a difficulty. For I said that Rabbi Chia, Inkwa Metzoi Meskoma, Rabbi Chia, who taught the Braisa, means to say that if one originally found the fetus dead inside its mother's womb, it is pure of conveying tuma through carrying. In the case where the fetus is found dead in the womb, even Rabbi Meir agrees that the mother's shchita is effective for it. Ledidoch, the entire Braisa accords with Rabbi Meir's opinion. Ela ledidoch kashio, but according to you, the difficulty I presented still stands. Since when questioned, You did not explain yourself as meaning that the fetus is pure of conveying tumor if it was originally found dead in the womb. You obviously mean literally that it is pure even if it was found alive and subsequently died. Thus, the mother's shechita affects purification even for a live full-term fetus. How can you reconcile this with your own ruling that the fetus may be eaten on the basis of its own shechita? Rabbi Chisda answers, Omar le, he said to Rabba le didi nami lo ikashi, according to me too, there is no difficulty because my rulings follow the opinion of the rabbis and they maintain that Arbo Simonim Achshar Berachmana, the merciful one, validated four pipes for the slaughter of a full-term fetus. Kisolik Rabbi Zeira, when Rabbi Zeira went up to Eretz Yisrael, Ashkechi Rabbi Asi Diosi V'komol Ela Shmaito, Rabbi Asi encountered him sitting and saying this preceding discourse of Rav Chisda. Omer Le, Rav Asi said to Rav Zeira, Yeshar, well said. V'chen Omer Rabbi Yochanan, and he said, and so he said to Rabbi Yochanan, Miklad de Poligal Rabbi Shimon Melakish. And so said Rabbi Yochanan. Miklad de Poligal Rabbi Shimon Melakish. Rabbi Zeira asked Rav Asi, since you mentioned only Rabbi Yochanan, do you mean to imply that Rabbi Shimon Melakish disagrees with him? Rav Asi responds, Misho Avi Shoyle. Reish Lakish would customarily wait for Rabbi Yochanan to conclude his discourse and review it. Veshosikle, and even if Reish Lakish took issue with it, he would remain silent for some time before voicing his objection. When Rabbi Yochanan taught this particular ruling, I left the study hall soon afterward, so I do not know whether Reish Lakish concurred or objected. Another version of Asi responds, V'ikadamu mishta v'shosi v'shosikle. Reish Lakish was drinking water at the time of Rabbi Yochanan, at the time that Rabbi Yochanan taught this ruling, and for that reason he was silent, even though quite possibly he disagreed with it. Since I left the study hall immediately afterward, I do not know whether Reish Lakish concurred or objected. Rabbi Shimon Shezur Eimer Afilu V'chulu, Rabbi Shimon Shezur says, even if the fetus was found alive in the womb, grew to be 5 years old and is plowing in the field, its mother Shechita has purified it so that it may be killed and eaten without Shechita. Ainu Tanakama, this is the same as the opinion of the Tanakama. In what way does Rabbi Shimon Shizuri disagree with him? The dispute is clarified. Omar Rav Kahana Ifris Al-Gav Ekarka Ikabinah. There's a difference between them regarding a case where the Ben Pekua placed its hooves on the ground. According to the Tanakama, it is permitted only if it is killed before it steps out of the womb. According to Rabbi Shimon Shezuri, however, it is permitted without Shechita, even if it has walked on the ground. The Gemara discusses the law that pertains to a Ben Pekua produces offspring. Omar Rav Shoshai, Rav Shoshai said, "Adiv Raimir Choshen Lezerav." According to the opinion of the one who says that we are concerned for the father's seed, Ben Pekua Bal Beimum Al Yosa. If Ben Pekua mounts a normal animal and produces an offering of Lad, Ein Lo Takono, the offspring has no means of rectification. That is, it cannot possibly be permitted for consumption.
How can we even talk about a female?
They will. Shechita can possibly be effective for this offspring on the basis of its paternal lineage. It is exempt from Shechita since the father, the Ben Pekua, was rendered permissible by his mother's Shechita and thus viewed as having already been slaughtered. The status is carried over to the father's young. The Gemara returns to the dispute mentioned in our Mishnah, focusing on a case in which the Nakama conceded to Rabbi Shimon Shezuri. Omar Abaye, Akol Moedim Bekol Ben Pekua, all agree regarding an animal with joined hooves, that is a Ben Pekua, Shemuto, that it is permissible for consumption without Shechita, even if it has placed its hooves on the ground. My time, or what is the reason? Anything extraordinary is remembered well by people. All agree regarding an animal with joined hooves, that is the offspring of a mother with joined hooves and is a ben pekua. Shemuta, that it is permissible for consumption without shchita, even if it has placed its feet on the ground. My time, what is the reason? The combination of two extraordinary things is remembered well by people. It says in 23, only when there is highly unusual combination of events, in that a fetus with joined hooves is taken from the womb of a slaughtered mother who also has joined hooves, do we rely upon people to remember this is a ben pekua and is permitted on the basis of its mother's shechita. Omar Zairi, Omar Bichanina. Rabbi Zairi said in the name of Bichanina, Aloha ki Rabbi Shimon ben Shizuri, the Aloha follows Rabbi Shimon Shizuri. וכן היה רבי שמעון שזורי מתיר בבנוי ובן בנוי עד צריך כל הדורות. רבי שמעון שזורי similarly permitted the ben pekua's offspring and the offspring of its offspring and so forth until the end of all generations to be eaten without שחיטה. רבי יוחנן אמר, הוא מותר ובנוי אסור. Ben pekua itself is permitted without שחיטה. Uvenoi also, but its offspring is forbidden unless it is slaughtered. Ada bar chavu avale ben pekua, then of a du balei. So obviously Rabbi Yochanan disagree with Rabbi Shimon Shizuri. Ada bar chavu or bar chavu had a grown ben pekua that was attacked and fatally injured by a wolf. Also, the Kamid Ravashi came before Ravashi to inquire whether it was permitted for consumption. Omar le'izir shachte. He said, go slaughter and eat it. So obviously, follows Rabbi Meir, that his shechita makes it kosher. Omar le'izir, he said to Ravashi, Omar zir, Omar chanin, aloha ki Rabbi Shimon ben Shizuri, but we learned aloha follows Rabbi Shimon ben Shizuri, even if it's 5 years old and plowing in the field, that you don't have to shecht it. וכן הרבי שמעון שזורי מתיר בבנו ובמנו צריך כל הדרס, הרבי שמעון שזורי similarly permitted them pekuas, not only it, also its offspring and the offspring of its offspring and so forth until the end of all generations to be eaten without שחיטה. ואפילו רבי יוחנן כאמר לבנוי, אבל יורו, and even רבי יוחנן who disagreed with Zairi said only that the ben pekua offspring requires shechita, but we're dealing with the ben pekua itself. Aval iu loy, but the ben pekua itself does not. Omar Rabbi Yochanan, Adiv Rabbi Shimon, he said to him, Rabbi Yochanan, Adiv Rabbi Shimon Shizuri. Come, Rabbi Yochanan was speaking according to the opinion of Rabbi Shimon Shizuri. That is, Rabbi Yochanan meant merely that even according to Rabbi Shimon Shizuri, only the ben pekua itself, but not its offspring, is permitted without shechita. He did not mean that the halacha follow this opinion. Omar Rabin bar Chanina Omar Ula Omar b'Chanina Halacha ki Rabbi Shimon Shizuri veloid Omar k'mishon Rabbi Shimon Shizuri b'mishnaseinu Halacha k'moisa. Now it makes it even more difficult because Rabin bar Chanina said in the name of Ula, who said in the name of Rabbi Chanina, the halacha follows Rabbi Shimon Shizuri, and furthermore, anywhere that Rabbi Shimon Shizuri taught a law in our Mishnah, the halacha follows him. Omar le ano ki asevira le. I concur with the following dissenting opinion. The Omar Rabbi Enoson, for Rabbi Enoson said, halacha ki Rabbi Shimon Shizuri b'mesukan. The halacha follows Rabbi Shimon Shizuri specifically in his ruling regarding a dangerously ill man. Uvisumas Meiser shall demai, and in his ruling regarding Tumis Meiser of the Mai, but not in other instance like in our case. We learn from Rabbi Enoson's teaching that in the case of Ben Pekua, the halacha follows the Tanakama, who states that once it has placed its feet the fetus places its feet upon the ground, it requires shechita. The Gemara quotes the ruling of Rabbi Shimon Shazuri that were just mentioned, Mesukan. The ruling regarding dangerously ill men, that none, is that which we learned in the Mishnah. Originally, the sages said, if one goes out in chains to be executed by the government, and he says on the way to the gallows, he says, Omar Kisvu Gate Leishti, and he says, write a get for my wife. They may write the get and give it to his wife. Chazu Loima, the sages later said, even one who sets out to sea and one who lives in a caravan to traverse deserts is subject to this law. That if he says, write a get, they should give the get to the wife. Rabbi Shimon Shazur says, Afa Mesukon, even a dangerously ill man is subject to this law. Look at 36, it says, if he merely instructs his agents to write a get, they may write and deliver it to his wife. According to Rabbi Shimon Shazuri, we may assume that any dangerously ill person is sufficiently disoriented due to the fear of death to overlook an instruction. The halacha follows Rabbi Shimon Shazuri in this regard. Rashi implies that this refers to any seriously ill person. For other interpretation of dangerously ill, see Rambam, Ilchot Girushim, Laws of Divorce. So Rabbi Shimon Shazur is teaching us that if a dangerously ill man says, write a get, you write a get. Or someone that is on the way to be executed, what's his benefit in writing a get?
The woman is free. You vomit again.
No, you vomit, so she doesn't have to be chayav of the
Or he doesn't want her to get money. Because if she's a widow, she inherits him.
Yeah.
If she's divorced, she gets nothing.
No, she still gets the
ksuba. What is the ksuba?
Yeah, 100, 300.
It could be also good because it could benefit her in a way. Because if she is a widow, she can marry a Kohen.
Oh, right.
And if she's divorced, she can't marry a Kohen. So if he knows that she has her eyes on a Kohen, and he wants to kill it.
Well, it depends which way you look at it.
So he can do that. Right, and or he want to save her from Yibum.
Right.
Or he wants to get her out of the inheritance.
What is better, to marry to a Kohen or have the inheritance? It depends.
It depends where she's holding and where he's holding and the whole thing.
So the Gemara quotes the ruling of Rabbi Shimon Shazui that were just mentioned, Mesukon, the ruling regarding a dangerously ill man, that none, which we learned in the Mishnah, originally the sages said, if one goes out in chains to be executed by the government, Ve'omar, kisvu get leishti. He says, write a get to my wife. Harelu iktivu ve'itnu. They may write the get and give it to his wife. Chozu leima, the sages later said, afa meforesh ha'itze b'shayoro, even one who sets out to sea, one who lives in a caravan to traverse deserts is subject to this law. Rabbi Shimon Shazuri says, afa mesukon, even a dangerously ill man is subject to this law. Tumas Maisa shel Demai, the ruling regarding Tumas Maisa of Demai, that none, we learned Demai is a food that we are not certain if it was tithed or not, maisa or tumas were given, we're not sure because it was an ama oretz. That now, which we learned, the Mishnah, tumas maisa, the maisa chozal mekrim, if tumas maisa of the mai returned to its original place, it became mingled with the produce from which it has been separated. Rabbi Shimon Shazur Emer Af Bechoil Shoyalo, even on a weekday, one may ask the seller whether he separated the required tithe, Ve'echlo Al Piv, and if he said that he did, one may eat the produce on his word. And with that, we concluded page 75.